Emmanuel, God is with us. I want to use this opportunity to extend my heart condolences to our mother in the Lord, Mrs. Evelyn Joshua, and to my sisters, Sarah Joshua, Promise Joshua, and Heart Joshua. May God Almighty continue to console you in this very difficult moment, in Jesus' mighty name. I also want to use this opportunity to say a few things about Senior Prophet T.B. Joshua, my father in the Lord, my mentor and my coach, my teacher. He is the one who took me as a small boy without having any biological connection with me. And he made me to be one of his sons. As you all know, Prophet T.B. Joshua, for so many years, more than 30 years, he has been ministering the Word of God, the prophetic gift, the gift of healing, gift of deliverance. He was a philanthropist. He was a helper to the needy, a companion to the lonely, a friend to the widows and the widowers. He has shared millions of bags of rice and supported financially so many people. I believe we cannot count how many people have been benefiting all these years from Prophet T.B. Joshua. Before he left this world, he said, and I quote, "The greatest way to use life is to spend it on something that will outlive it." I repeat, the greatest way to use life is to spend it on something that will outlive it. I believe Prophet T.B. Joshua, this is what he was born for, this is what he lived for, and this is what he died for. To write a history that will remain hereafter. Now, he has ascended to be with the Lord. He has become part of the saints in heaven, in the presence of God. And we, his sons and daughters of Prophet T.B. Joshua, we are here to tell our own part of story. We are here to write our own history. And believe me, there is no way we can talk about our history without mentioning Prophet T.B. Joshua. Prophet T.B. Joshua has played the greatest part in my life personally, because I know how I went to Synagogue Church of All Nations in Lagos, Nigeria. I went there as nobody, and he made me to become somebody. I went there as a young boy who did not know anything. And Prophet T.B. Joshua, my father, took me as his son and patiently taught me the way of the Lord. Patiently, he taught me the Word of God. He taught me how to do the right thing. He taught me how to preach and teach the Word of God. He taught me how to pray. And like many others who have received an impartation, me too. I'm one of them who received impartation, a part of the Holy Spirit that has been working through Prophet T.B. Joshua. Now some people, they may begin to ask questions, how is it possible? This is not possible. But believe me, through the teachings of Prophet T.B. Joshua. His spirit is still much around us. Through his teachings, through his messages, as long as you keep them in your heart and you make use of them, you practice them, believe me, you will continue to be used by God Almighty at the level that God permits. Now, what can I say? The few things I can say at this moment is that for so many years, Prophet T.B. Joshua showed us the example of a Christian. He has been a role model to all of us. He worked tirelessly, day and night, in teaching us the way of the Lord. Millions of people all over the world, through Emmanuel TV, we have seen what the Lord Almighty has been using him to do. All these years, thousands upon thousands of disciples have passed through the ministry of Synagogue Church of All Nations to learn under Prophet T.B. Joshua. And he was never tired. He took his time. He invested his time in every one of us, one by one, to teach us the way of the Lord. He helped us to build a character of Christ. He helped us to become men and women of faith. Many of us, we came to the Synagogue Church of All Nations without vision, and he helped us to discover ourselves. He helped us to find the purpose of our lives and to have a vision in our lives. I want to say that the legacy Prophet T.B. Joshua left behind, it is us. We are his legacy. As long as we continue to be faithful to the Lord Almighty and to the teachings that we received from Prophet T.B. Joshua, we will be his legacy. So, I have one or two words to also advise to all the men and women of God all over the world. We're supposed to learn from Prophet T.B. Joshua. Many of the men and women of God who have come in this world did not have the time to train other people to do God's work. But Prophet T.B. Joshua created the time. You see, you will never find the time to do the right thing. You must create the time to do the right thing. So men and women of God all over the world, let us learn from the life of Prophet T.B. Joshua. And let us pass that knowledge, that wisdom, that grace we have received to the next generation. Because the hour of our death is uncertain. Nobody knows what the future holds. Look at how young Prophet T.B. Joshua has passed on to glory. At the age of 57, almost 58 years old. Very soon, it will be June 12. It does not matter how long, but how well. This is one of the teachings of Prophet T.B. Joshua. Let us run well the race. Let us walk the way of the Lord without turning the Bible to make it suit to our own philosophy. Jesus said, go to the whole world and make disciples. Freely you have received, freely you should give.
एंजल ब्रोकिंग के नए आई ट्रेड प्राइम प्लान पे अब पाइए जीरो ब्रोकरेज और साथ ही फ्री मार्जिन ट्रेड फंडिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट 30 डेज. ध्यान रहे लिमिटेड पीरियड ऑफर. इन्वेस्टमेंट्स इन सिक्योर.
सो मेन एंड वुमेन ऑफ गॉड, लेट अस वर्क द सेम वे आवर फादर इन द लॉर्ड प्रोफेट टीबी जोशुआ वर्कड टायरलेसली. डोंट गिव अप ऑन पीपल, गिव देम द अपॉर्चुनिटी to correct their mistakes. Be patient with them. Don't be too quick to judge and send them away from the presence of God. Just like somebody has been patient to you all these times, you have done the wrong thing. So let us humble ourselves. Prophet T.B. Joshua, show us the way of humility. I can say boldly before everyone that he is the most humble man I've ever known in my whole life. The most humble man. Despite the blessings God has given him, he never used the blessings to show off and to live a flamboyant life. He never tried to show people how blessed, how rich he was. But instead, he was always with simple clothing, walking in the midst of people, showing them that he too, he is a human being. Another thing I can say about what I have learned from Prophet T.B. Joshua is this. He told us a few days after we had received our own anointing, our own calling to do the work of God and to minister in the Synagogue Church of All Nations. He said, listen carefully. The more God Almighty uses you, the more God Almighty glorifies you, the more God Almighty shows His grace upon your life and upon your ministries, the more you should humble yourself. Don't think that anything is of you. Everything we have comes from God. Everything we are comes from God. So why anyone should be proud and be talking as if he owns the whole universe? The departure of Prophet T.B. Joshua showed us that we are all human beings. Let us humble ourselves and allow God Almighty to use us for His glory. In the end of the day, when the time comes, everybody will return back to Him. The question, will you be ready to meet Him one day? I have so many things to say, but time will not permit me. Daddy, Prophet T.B. Joshua, you will always remain in my heart as a dearest father. And I promise to keep all your teachings and your messages in the midst of my heart. I'm going to teach the world what you have taught me. And I'm going to pass over to other people what I have received from God Almighty through you. I want you to be proud of all of us, because I believe The success of every father is to train his children to the level that his children will be able to stand on their own and do what the father has taught them to do. So, farewell, my daddy. I will see you on the other side.